This is Morning Express, and well, great that you're here with us. It's time for us to go for Hot Topics. It's now 7 minutes after seven. But before we begin and go for the song of the week, well, let's start first of all by introducing the panel that we have this morning. And I'll start with my extreme left, where we have Adhiambo Odera, pop culture specialist. And today I can see, what are those things called? Those things you had last week?
Cornrows?
Are those cornrows? They're bigger than cornrows. They're just two of them. But anyway, yes. I see the new hairstyle. Good to have you. Good morning. How have you been?
Good morning.
You're well?
Mike, I've been well. It's okay. Been fantastic. It's okay. Good to see you.
Good to have you and good to see you as well. We also have Stevens Mwenda, who is editor for The Pulse. Good to have you as well.
Good to have you,
looking
Mike.
Sharp. Is there an occasion you want to tell us about
after the
show?
One, Mike.
Oh, yes. It's a lifestyle. Yeah. Your weakness. I say no more. I say no more. I got the right there. Last but not least, we have Zinzi Kibiku, who is a reporter with KTN News, and good to have you as well.
I must say thank you. Look at the golden tie he's wearing today.
Looking very good. And let me start with you, Zinzi. What has been a hot topic for you this week?
Netanyahu.
What about him? The fact that he has a sense of humor.
That mm-hmm. and also...
Which came by surprise.
Yes, true. After the whole closing of the roads. And then, you know, he plays it lightly during the dinner with Mr. President.
Oh, yeah.
Later on, he walked his dog on Wayakiwe. Oh, my goodness. And I swear that dog has traveled more countries than me.
I know. Like and I wonder how they transport it. Because, you know, normally animals are not carried where humans are. It's required somewhere.
Yeah. And, you know, so they have passports.
Because yes,
I have a friend who does the same thing, and the dog has a passport. I'm like, is this possible?
Yes.
Like, dogs have passports.
Very possible. Animals have passports.
But they're not dogs, they're police guys. So
actually, they're agents. Yeah. They're agents. Yes. When Steve, I know you have. If you don't have a passport and Netanyahu's dog has a passport, that is really sad. So please make sure that you get yourself a passport.
If you have somewhere to go anyway, because some guys are not ambitious to leave the country or go anywhere, so you don't get a passport.
Hey, no, but still, just have a passport and put it in your handbag. You know what? You just dream.
Yes,
even if you're not going anywhere, if you're going to Busia, just have a passport and say, who knows, I might cross the border.
Yeah, by the way.
I mean, it's sad for a dog to have a passport if you don't have one. Anyway, Stevens, what has been a hot topic
for you? A lot has
been
happening, but just the story about the lawyer again, mm-hmm. and then it's been a big story in town. But again, showbiz talking, I call he and the mini photo of our said wedding, that rocks this town. And still a big story right now.
Okay. Adhiambo, what has been hot for you?
One thing, Madonna. You know,
yes.
There are few people like me who can only go by one name. You know, you don't need to say the second one. If you say Madonna, you say Raila, you say Jesus, or you say Adhiambo, you know.
So I should stop introducing you as Adhiambo Odera. I should just say Adhiambo.
No, one name.
Full stop.
Yeah,
okay. Madonna.
Yeah, I was, yeah.
Right. Okay, so that was a hot topic for you. And of course, we'll be talking about that as we go along. But for now, we'd like to start with a song of the week. And this week, do you want to introduce a song of the week? This morning, she was summarizing Miss Siju pronunciation of Siju word name. So please, I will give you the opportunity to introduce the song of the week.
We couldn't pronounce Yemi Alade, Yemi Alade.
Yeah. Yes, Yemi. So can you show him how?
Yemi Alade.
Yeah, Yemi Alade.
It's that's what I said, Yemi Alade.
Last time you said Yemi Yalade.
Yeah.
Right. You added a yo. Potato.
Yeah. So this song coming up is Yemi Alade with Sauti Sol. It's called Africa. It's only 2 days old. I haven't personally watched it, so I'm also excited to see him.
I had the beat and it's very, well, it's...
As expected, let's see. Let's be wild.
Song of the week before we go to Hot Topics. What do you call it? Beautiful scenery.
And images. That Madonna didn't take.
Beautiful like Africa.
Like,
you know,
Africa.
And like we say sometimes ago, it's how amazing how our artists are just taking us back to embracing our very own land.
Proud of it.
And that was big. I like the video, Mike. It's amazing. If you just look at the lyrics, the way she starts, or when and the way she rhymes, and now... Well complemented with good visuals and all that. I think it's a beautiful...
It gives a very nice picture of Africa. Right. And this morning, the question we were asking was whether the pictures, especially celebrities take, are a true reflection of Africa. And of course, it's not that the pictures are fake, but sometimes you can give a certain story or a narrative depending on what you choose to display. And looking at Madonna and the picture that she has taken, or rather, and we were showing it earlier on, And it was written, Madonna with Samburu in Kikuyu Valley.
Yeah.
And at some point, I thought, okay, I am in Kenya, but I'm trying to remember where Kikuyu Valley is.
People should know that Madonna was around in the first place.
Yeah.
She didn't Photoshop that.
Yes.
She was around. She was around. Right. That's for sure. Although it was a very quiet visit.
Yes.
I hosted Kennedy Odede, who was her host here in Kenya. And apparently she really just wanted her children to come and go to Kibera because of what Kennedy is doing. And by the way, he's doing some amazing
work. I watched.
In Kibera.
Yeah.
It's really, really amazing what he's doing. But anyway, coming back to Madonna, she didn't want it as a public, thing. Mm. So she was actually in Kenya. However, of course, the pictures she posted. I'm still trying to find out where Kikuyu Valley is.
No, ask the guy you hosted the other day from Google Maps. He probably...
Oh, yes.
Google Maps has Kikuyu Valley.
Charles Morito.
Yes,
from Google. Yeah, maybe he should come and... we should have actually Googled and checked where Kikuyu Valley is. I will definitely catch up with him and ask him.
But more seriously, though, I think that a lot of celebrities, when they wear their charity hat, sometimes they're really overwhelmed by, you know, that other side of theirs, that they don't probably check their facts right. Mm-hmm. That was not the only photo that ached people, by the way. There are some people who are very pissed off about the fact that she posted a photo and said that is where the drinking water comes from in Nairobi, in the slums. We appreciate and nod to the fact that we probably have the biggest slum in Africa according to how we have sold it, but there are things about us that are still beautiful, like the song Yemi Alade has put out with Sauti Sol.
And even the falls and the water that was in the background, you have a lot of water. So, however, maybe what she was saying, and maybe it's whoever posted that, because I did go to Kibera, on Wednesday, and part of what Kennedy was showing us is that literally that river, there are people who drink water from that river, sadly. That is a fact.
Listen, I think Madonna is doing great. First of all, bringing her kids down so she can see how hard life gets, and for them to appreciate it more. I understand that. That was amazing for her. You know, kudos. I like the fact she's come also on charity basis, even better. I like the fact that she even came on a quiet matters, like they said. Right. But then again, those certain pictures that, you know, we're depicting of Africa, we're feeding into the stereotypes that, oh, Africa, you guys just live in huts. You guys only wear this.
Skin.
And the thing is, there's nothing wrong with that, like you said. Some of it is the truth. Mm. And yes, we should be proud of our culture. But you see, I liked someone's comment online, and they said, why is it that when you're at Masai Mara or the luxury hotel you stay, why can't you also not take a photo of that one? If you're going to take a photo of Kibera, fine, well and done. Mm. You know,
but balance also take... It.
Thank you. Yeah. Take also a photo of that fancy hostel you're staying in, that dining, you know.
Mm. When she takes the hot air balloon in Amboseli for crying out loud, she needs to be able
do
to show the world
there.
Yes.
Right.
So there you go, Madonna, in case you're watching. Maybe she got attached to Kenya and she's watching for whatever reason.
And we were concerned.
She's in Malawi, though, right now.
Yeah, she's gone back. You know, she loves Malawi, though.
Two of her children are from Malawi.
Yeah, they're right there. However, let's just tell her one thing. Next time, just give us a concert as well and wear those interesting things.
Yeah, because people like me kept on thinking, you are seeing the first lady. That's a beautiful thing.
However, concert.
Kebra, you have done a good thing. You're going all the way to Masai Mara, but the Pulse needs you.
Yes, to do a show. Yes.
No, but she's allowed to come and undercover and do whatever she wants to do.
Even
when she comes as Madonna the pop star, then of course she
Mike,
will.
When we go places undercover, we also do things.
Mm-hmm. We still do other things,
which she did in Kibra. The children in Kibra loved
that. In collab with Octopizzo, perhaps, now that he was Octopizzo's back here.
But also Octopizzo called her out on those photos.
That's what I'm saying. They could have done a collab. It would have been nice.
Yeah. Anyway, moving away from Madonna, but I think we've got the point across, and I'll still read some of the comments that are coming in regards to the question, whether it's a true reflection of Africa. And of course, majority would say no. However, pictures don't lie. So it is fact. It's just now we need that balance. We need that balance in between. But coming back to Hot Topics and what's been going on, and of course, last weekend was gruesome. It was really, really sad. Yeah. I remember, first of all, there was the 8 girls who were involved in a car accident. And what for me was really sad is the fact that there was a possibility that, first of all, the driver they had was not that experienced in long-distance driving. And I just hope that he was not under the influence of alcohol.
Mm.
Yeah, because, I mean... those young girls, I mean, we had the pictures and there you go. They took selfies just before leaving and they were going for a party. But so sad.
It is. They're in their 20s. I think one of the saddest things on earth is that when you lose people that young. These are tomorrow's generations. These are our doctors, our lawyers, our sisters, our
brothers,
you know, our presidents. Mm. It's sad when you lose people at such a young age, not even to road accidents. You've had those stories when a child passes away from a certain disease, like it really aches you.
Oh, yeah.
This person hasn't lived their life. Mm. Mm. Yeah. Mm.
They're just beginning.
Yeah, it's a very sad story.
We love the
club place. We like to party. We love to have fun. And like she says, God forbid that guy wasn't an influence of something. And the thing is, the rules are right. The laws are there. Mm. Don't overindulge. Mm. Don't drink and drive. We don't demonize them for whatever else happened. But it's a lesson for all of us that really, even when you go to party and then when you're told don't drink and drive, things like that, it's for your own good end of the day. I see so many guys, you know, you get high and you're trying to avoid those guys. Mm-hmm. And you're just thinking, end of the day, you're going to your house, you are taking care of your life, you're taking care of your families and everything. It's for us to internalize that I'm not just here to keep the law and just not be caught somewhere. Matters of ethics and stuff, we should really be careful about our lives, even as young people.
Look at those three lorries.
Oh my God,
along Thika.
When did that happen?
That photo popped up right after the Kisii incident.
What was wrong
And
with
remember,
them?
There was also it must have been one of the trucks that hit the other two and, of course, caused that. Remember, there was also the incident in Limuru, where a truck hit, was it seven cars?
Yes. And, yeah, it was like back to back.
Literally,
there were about
10
of them.
It was a pileup. But coming back to the drink drive thing, because, you know, we even had a debate and we're asking, you know, who's at fault, really? And, of course, there's NTSA, there's the police, and we go around in circles. But at the end of the day, we also have a responsibility. Yeah. And I'll give you an example. Every morning on Monday when I'm coming to work, I pass a certain club. I don't want to mention which one it is. But what amazes me is that at that time,
we know.
For those who don't know, I'll just keep it that way. But what amazes me is that every Monday, this is Monday morning, and this always shocks me. Every Monday morning when I'm driving to work, this is like at what, 4:30, 4:45?
Right.
The place is packed.
Yeah.
With cars. So my thinking is, whoever has been there all night, it's okay, you have your fun, blah, blah, blah. But who's going to drive those cars after that?
Mm. They will drive them.
Michael, you see,
they will drive them.
True. Mm. Plus, and that's sad. Mm. Yeah. But you see what Michael is saying? I think in this case, we can't just point one finger to someone and say, okay, it's the girl. Okay, it's the driver. So it's the NTSA.
Right.
I feel like the responsibility is shared on all of us. First of all, if you've done long distance driving, it's fun, it's amazing, you know.
But you get
tired. You get to see. Exactly. Mm. I feel like when you always have a driver, have a co-driver. That person is a human being. They'll get sleepy, they'll get bored, their mind may go other places. Have a co-driver even with your driver. That's one. Two, always check up on them. It doesn't hurt for you to check up on the driver. Like, what is happening? Okay, we good.
Yeah. No, I like how you're saying it. You know why?
Yeah.
Because I know KU as an alumni, by the way. I'm saddened by really what happened. But if you have ever been in campus or college, then you know how on a Thursday plans pop up. Like, you probably were not even planning to leave.
Right.
Your friend has a party, and it's an all-white party. Mm. Surely there is no way you're 21 and 22 and you do not want to have fun. Mm. Let's begin from there. Mm. These people had all the right to have fun. Mm. They had all the right to travel where they were going. Mm. It is unfortunate, though, that what happened.
Mm.
I think we're also forgetting the one thing, that two of them were sisters. And actually from one mother, and they had lost somebody before that.
Yes, in fact, the mother was blaming herself, saying that the reason why she feels maybe this may have happened, they were supposed to go for a funeral, but they colluded with the aunties and said, no, let them not go, because they were very close to the cousin who had died, and they felt that they were going to be very dramatic during the funeral. Dramatic here means they might faint. In fact, she says they were thinking they'll faint, they'll scream, they'll shout. So they stopped them from going. The aunties went, left them at home. Then
that is what happened. Like I always say, Mike, and you, as a man of God, and you always quote this, I'll quote it again. Man composes, but I think God disposes. And in this case, let their souls rest in peace. The other thing that happened in KU, which has been sad, I think KU has just been a sad place this time, was the guy who also committed suicide.
Oh, yeah, the guy who spent his 80,000 shillings worth of fees.
And due to gambling?
Gambling. Yeah. Which, of course, is another thing that now has become, let me call it a disease in Kenya, because there's a lot of money to be won.
Yeah.
But obviously, the rationale behind it is everybody wants to be a winner. But some people now have gone to the point where you go beyond the scale and literally spend all your money trying to win that break.
Yeah. People have lost a lot of money this week, actually, betting on football.
Mm. I know.
Last night and the other night. And Mike, gambling is I don't know if it's a good thing or not. I don't myself. I don't bet. Mm-hmm. Okay?
It's addictive for
I work very hard to make my...
So you're not giving it away?
The thing is...
You're not risking it.
You see so many young guys... And it's becoming a culture in Nairobi that guys have stopped to go to work or to look for jobs, to sit down in the house, and buy the newspaper in the morning, see what's happening, and start betting and stuff. Yeah. It's working for some. I've had some have made millions, and they're making a living out of it. That's a good thing. Mm. But when you have to gamble, then and it has to be your school fees.
Yeah.
And you start.
You know, for me, I can tell you from my own experience, I gambled once, and that was the end. It was 20 bob. And
where
I was, you know, those things. No, it was those
jukebox.
By the way, it was a street Kitambo. I'll not tell you how long ago this was, but those guys were Patapotea. This was long
this
time
was
ago. No, long time ago. I'm just giving you my experience that for me, that right. I decided gambling upon that guy. He was amazing because he'd show you the cards,
yes,
then you know that he'd put it down and you just do this,
yeah,
then he tells you where is the ace. And for me, I put my 20 bob there. I was amazed.
Those ones downtown.
Downtown, Kabisa. But the feeling is the same. That 20 bob, honestly, I felt so much pain. And I decided I will never, ever, 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 ever gamble.
I completely agree with Stevens. Let me tell you, you wake up at 5 a.m. to come to work. And then I go gamble my money, the little I'm making. Never.
It's not going to happen.
It's not going to happen. Not under this. No.
What if you're in Las Vegas, though? You know, like the way those things just call.
Even though it's in Las Vegas.
And you know, unfortunately, the statistics show that most people who have won, even those who've won the jackpot, end up poorer over a period of time.
Yeah.
Because it's not about how much money you have, but the fact that they get this money and they don't even know what to do with it. And suddenly you live in the best side of town, you drive the biggest car, you are bowling for a year or two after that.
Mike, I think this was, again, made for some people. Like you're saying.
On gambling.
When you have to really be gambling, you really have to have the real money. And that's what most young people don't understand. Mm. Even when you're doing the 50 shillings thing, the 100 bob, and there's a guy who wakes up in the morning and thinks, I have a million to deal with in the casinos, for example, today. And I wish Smita was here.
Because
he's a gambler.
And he probably went.
He
could have been.
I know. He was in
He's in Watamu, probably. And you know, that's where those guys would be. And the guys who wake up in the morning, real rich guys, and who wake up and go to the casinos and bet real big money. And that's.
For them, it's not a dent on their pocket.
If a guy has a million to dispose, and now you are disposing 80,000 shillings,
which is the only money you have. Unfortunately, let his soul rest in peace as well. But I think that people need to do things in moderation. I mean, it's a little bit too much to take your fee and then cry later. Now look at how the parents are. It's a little bit too much to imagine that people need to be sorry for you.
Yeah.
For things that you did knowingly.
You
don't walk into something and say, oh my God, I saw the fire, I walked anyway.
Yeah. Anyway. It's been quite a sad week. Also, the other thing that's been major for the last week and a half to 2 weeks is the extrajudicial killings in Kenya. And of course, this is brought to light by the lawyer, Willie Kimani, the boda-boda guy, and the taxi driver, which, of course, has brought to light many things. One of them being the fact that we do really have some rogue policemen out there, and there's a systemic issue. But of course, this has brought about the debate. That's another, you know, sad thing that took place this week.
I was having a conversation with a friend yesterday, and she was telling me there's a time her and her husband went to report a case. Mm-hmm. And the people who were serving, the police, whoever he or she was, who were serving them at the front desk, were so rude.
Uh-huh.
Were so rude. And the thing is, she's not the first person who has complained about police service in Kenya. Mm. We tend to forget that police, it's one of those careers upheld highly.
Right.
At the same level with in being a doctor and being a lawyer, because you're serving the people. When people see you, they see security. When you see a cop, you're like, easy. In other places, you see a cop and you freak out.
Okay.
You want to report a crime?
Lately, of course, lately.
Exactly. Yeah. You want to report a crime, but you can't because you know that policeman, A, will not help you. Two, will end up probably just being as violent, be it verbal or physically, as whoever it is you're going to report. I feel like we are losing as society, not only here in Kenya, but also in America from what we're seeing. Mm. The essence of being a security officer, it was upheld so highly. You see one and you're safe.
Yeah, but you see, I think traditionally in Kenya, right, police officer was viewed as authoritarian, mm-hmm, and that's why it was a police force, which through the reforms was supposed to be changed to a police service. Mm-hmm. And I remember one time even being stopped by a police, traffic police officer, and I told him, sometimes me, I somehow them, and they don't like it, but I told him, listen, your responsibility is not to harass me.
Exactly.
One, it's to inform. Mm. Two, correct. Fine, if you're going to give me a ticket and all that, that's fine, but do it, you know, in a proper way, not to make me feel like you're literally just there to harass me, which is unfortunate, which is what the police now seem to be battling with.
I watched you actually when you were with the police spokesman,
Charles Owino.
Yes, mm-hmm. He has some valid points as well, because of the things that have been happening earlier on, we are also not looking at policemen like they can also help us. There's been a shift of perspective in how we look at them. And he simply said that our baby Rungu, you know, they have live live bullets in there, and at some point they can actually be able to use them. Mm. However, let's go back to the extrajudicial killing and the demonstrations that were there, which for me, I think that was really very good picketing. It looked so real, the thing that was done by Boniface Mwangi and the lawyers and how they're going about it, because those are their people, and it's not a good thing to wake up one day and because you want justice, you die because of it. So I think there has got to be a balance between how us as citizens are going to be looking at how the police is supposed to give a service. And there's a gap somewhere. There is need for us to dialogue and actually be able to agree, especially because now that election year is coming. Yes, there's need for dialogue between police and citizens. Yeah.
No, I'm laughing about something else.
Maybe it's because that word dialogue has been used in certain quarters.
Right.
Yeah.
Allow me to compliment Adhiambo's comment. Let me also add on top, I don't know if I was in town when the LSK walk was happening. Let's talk about that protest for a while. And I feel like, I hope not only ODM protesters, but all Kenyans are watching. Those guys did it so respectfully. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So well.
They went down, they had their voice heard, as in they did it in such a manner. Peace protest is the word I'm looking for.
It was good.
Until my people down the road, Mulolongo, where this thing is supposed to have happened, did not become that peaceful, and that's why, again, I'm just laughing because I'm just thinking police, and we're talking about police dialogue and reforms and all that dialogue. And there's an MP on the run because he's scared of the police again.
Oh God!
Because they went to burn down
the containers.
Exactly.
I didn't understand.
And now they're looking for him. Like, dude, you're in charge of this thing, so we are coming after you. And the guy is gone missing. And
so MIA.
Sometimes you just look at the way we relate again with the police force again. And it's not all of them that are bad. Mike, we have enough of them that even some are in studio who are even Christians who will say we are not for bribe or for all these other things at the end of the day. Mm. But when you talk about police again, you're just thinking about the police reforms, which are supposed to be in place right now.
And unfortunately, really negative things take more time than positive, because there are some police officers who are genuine. There are some who will not take a bribe. There are some who will literally be very cordial, even as they are getting dispensing their work. But unfortunately, those voices are very few, and then they are sunk. But this problem of policemen seems not to just be a Kenyan problem.
Yes.
And of course, in the U.S., there's been what's been happening. And maybe for anybody who may not be or have not seen, we have some footage of what's been going on. And of course, there's always been the fight between white policemen and blacks and the fact that they're killed. But here's some footage and video before we discuss that of what's been going on. And this is chilling.
We got pulled over for a busted tail light in the back, and the police just he's covered. He killed my boyfriend. He's licensed to carry. He was trying to get out his ID and his wallet out his pocket, and he let the officer know that he had a firearm and he was reaching for his wallet, and the officer just shot him in his arm. We're waiting for a back. I will, sir. No worries. I will.
Fuck.
He just shot his arm off. We got pulled over on Larpiner.
I told him not to reach for it. I told him to get his hand off it.
You told him to get his ID, sir, and his driver's license. Oh, my God, please don't tell me he's dead. Please don't tell me my boyfriend just went like that.
Keep your hands where they are, please.
Yes, I will, sir. I'll keep my hands where they are.
And I must say that she's extremely brave to even think and do that while he's lying right there. As you can see, there's a gun pointed at him. And, I mean...
Can I have a go at this, Michael? Can I be the first one to have a go at this
please
one?
Please do.
Woo! All right, so where do I begin? First of all, that video was taken live on Facebook. Yeah? And the thing is, you will notice even from the video, she's told, don't do anything. Don't move. If she wanted to help her boyfriend, she couldn't.
She can't.
She can't. Because again, she'd probably be another victim, another life lost like that. But also as we're on that case for Facebook, Facebook tried to bring it down. Apparently they were saying it's a technical hitch. Facebook tried to bring it down, Twitter would bring it up again. Because the issue, there's the notion of, there's this issue of freedom, yeah? And we talked about this last week.
Yes, with the song
even after
from
the BET
Beyonce,
Awards, yeah. And them talking about freedom and also what we've been seeing. Between that time and now, we've lost so many lives. Between his, because that was the guy known as Philando,
right.
Yeah, back in Minnesota. Mm. Before that, we had Alton Sterling,
yes.
Literally a day before.
The day before.
These are men in their 30s. Mm. These are men who have kids. Mm. You will, in that same video, they have their daughter with them. Then their daughter at some point, if you watch that 10 minutes video, the daughter tells mom, don't worry, it's going to be okay. Mm. And the mother at the end comes out. It's so sad. And the thing is, this has also affected one of our Kenyans there. We lost a 17-year-old boy. I remember reading it on one of our dailies, who was also shot for the same issue. Yeah. And they always confuse it for something. You could literally be holding a pen. If you look at the video for Alton, which we haven't played, but... The video for Alton, he literally has nothing on him.
Right.
He's pinned down by two cops.
Right.
He's shot on the chest and on the back. And this has become an issue. And that's why bringing back home, we're talking about police service. How you see a police and you see security and it's upheld highly.
Right.
But that's not the case. These are black people who have been fighting for this for a long time. We've seen it in the movies. We've seen it in the series. We've seen them trying to push for the message. Mm. We've seen artists, even today, Chris Brown has a video going around Instagram, him being so frustrated.
And still as you're going on, Zinzi, right, this is live, something that's happening right now. Breaking news of 11 officers shot dead, shot, not sure if they're dead yet. And that's, if we can see where that is, that's actually breaking news. We'll bring it to you as we continue. Police, two suspects in custody. And I don't know what is going on. It just seems to be crazy.
I mean, the age of Obama was expected to be a different thing for for the black man in America, for example. And until we are there to get the full of understanding of this, we may never even know how this feels. Police, the black person, and all that. And like you say, musicians have been on a campaign mode come on, this must stop, end of the day. And you're just thinking of, even again, the campaigns that are going on. And you can see who is making noise about what, what color of people and all that kind of thing. Mm. It's really, really sad.
It's sickening. And the thing is that there have been protests for the past 2 days in Orlando, even outside White House, if I'm not wrong, because everyone has their hands up saying, do not shoot. Mm. And we've seen also the hashtag Black Lives Matter coming up
right.
again.
They matter.
And I think people need to understand one thing. Yeah, the Black Lives Matter isn't a hashtag to show that the black race is more superior. And that's why we get it wrong sometimes. That Black Lives Matter hashtag is there to show, to bring attention. Yeah? And I remember after that hashtag came out, we saw All Lives Matter to kind of counter-check that.
Yeah.
But people need to remember that Black Lives Matter, that hashtag began not to show that the black skin is more inferior, but to bring awareness of what's happening. Mm. This is not something that happened yesterday or 20 years ago. Mm. It's been going on for a long time.
It's really sad. It's
sad. And you know, similar to the narrative that is being pushed, you have two stories that are run, one run by the state, one run by the people. And if you look at the Kenyan situation, you have the narrative of the state saying, this is not a police, don't say it's the police who are rogue. Mm. They're individuals. Mm. They're people who have gone wanton with their gun and killed somebody. So don't, blanket and put the whole. And then if you look at the US, it's the same thing where you have the police saying, look, why does it always have to be black and white? These are just criminal police officers who have shot. But the truth of the matter is, it just seems to be coming from the state.
And the answer to that, Michael, the answer for do not bring this as a police thing because they're individuals. I feel like my answer to that is that at the end of the day, there's no justice. Mm. Because why are we not seeing this? If you're saying that they are individuals, then take that individual to court.
Yes.
Yes, and where's the responsibility, even on that, the fact that you've been given the responsibility of security, then it of course behooves you to be very responsible with that office. And anybody who does not use that office properly, then should be dealt with.
Mike, it symbolizes that you have broken the law.
Yes.
And it is not something that happens. I mean, for example, how comes a white police officer does not shoot another white police officer?
It's
something you've already thought about. You've looked at this guy. I should believe as this is not us. And so we don't need them. And if I shoot them, as much as there's law, it will not go to the end of the day. I mean, these things get forgotten. And we had Obama, even now on his last days in office, talking about this, and it seems to be escalating every day. And that's what we're thinking. Why is this happening at this time?
Oh, and Stevens has a point. Is that a Manchester? Okay, but Stevens, Stevens has a point there. If this, sad to say, was a black man who shot a white person unarmed, the whole world would have come to a standstill. And yes, right now it's being brought to attention, but sad to say it's not being given the same attention and quick attention that it would have. It needs to be deserved. This year alone, guess how many people we've lost? In 2016 alone, to police brutality, unarmed, about 586
black
people.
There's so many black people.
And people forget, even when you discuss this stuff in America, I mean, it's sometimes how we seem to distance ourselves and say, what has it got to do with us? Our relatives are there. Our people are there. And this is human.
And our policemen are watching.
You know.
Okay, so yeah, the other thing that, you know, happened was also Pistorius. Oscar Pistorius was sentenced to 6 years. And of course, that's a story that had grabbed literally the whole world as the court proceedings was going on. I remember one of the things that happened when he was trying to defend himself is on one of the days he came to court without, or rather he was walking across court without his prosthetic. Legs, but anyway, he was sentenced to 6 years, which some felt was not justice.
He's actually still gonna do like about just three or two of those eventually, I'm sure.
And I bet he'll be comfortable.
Yeah, he's not gonna do the six because I think he'll probably be very well behaved, and he had a very good team that is defending him. The law, as we always say, is such an ass because it depends on who it is that is defending you and how well you actually can be able to put your facts right. I mean, he just said he didn't know who was in the house. And this is your girlfriend. Or something.
And he used a gun to kill a rat.
Yes, I think for him that was the quickest thing.
Oh, he had said he thought it was a thug. Actually.
Yeah, he thought it's a thug. Yeah. Yeah. But generally, the law, I think when you can get the best lawyers and they can be able to get you off the hook, then that's it. And that's according to everybody's justice. But you can't bring back the dead, you know, unfortunately, even if whatever we do, 6 years or even three, he'll be out. He probably will win another, you know, those things.
But I guess justice sometimes is very difficult to understand. Remember, we also had Chomley who literally just shot somebody in his farm. And within a very short time, he had already been let go because, well, good behavior.
Yeah, good behavior. Yeah. And then you have somebody,
I think we had a story not too long ago of a guy who stole a chicken. Okay. And he was put in for 10 years.
Yeah, yeah. And his behavior must not have been very nice.
Are you serious?
From this side of our world.
From
our people.
talking about this sentence again.
And somebody, one of the directors, is telling you, if you're from Luya Land, of course, stealing chicken, that's not good behavior. But anyway, that's.
What are channeling stories?
Messi also this week and the dad was
the mess that is Messi.
The mess that Messi gets himself in a messy.
It's sad to say, but how social media was comparing Messi and Ronaldo.
Yes.
Ronaldo appears in the football pitch, Messi appears in jail. It's so sad.
No,
he's only 29 years old. The guy has such a long life ahead of him.
Messi, really?
Yeah.
Messi in a messy situation. But then again, as we said, he may actually not do time per se, because according to their law, he could actually just, do some social work and
It is true, Mike, but again, if you get the mood here, it's Messi and CR7, and that's football for you.
Yeah.
And the debate has been, who is the greatest? Mm-hmm. I mean, Euro is happening. Mm-hmm. CR7 is doing so well.
Of course.
You know, to the finals now and all that. Mm. And the other guy is battling
And he chooses to go to jail because he's not going to jail. But this, funny enough, comes right after he's retired.
Yes.
He decides to put the ball down.
Not just retired, bitterly. After big loss.
I see you are Cristiano's side completely. You're not the other side.
He's a Ronaldo fan.
I think he's a Ronaldo guy because, there's always two sides. There's the side of the Messiah and then there's the side of the only
but
side.
But the truth is out there, though. Who is the greatest now?
Yeah, so anyway, going back to the wheels of justice, and apparently the reason why Solo is not here is, he sent what me an SMS doing? And told me that he's been arrested. But we have it so long.
Arrested by police.
By a police. WPC in UK, they're called WPC, Woman Police Constable. Uh-huh. But first of all, let's hear from Solo. Apparently, we've got him on line. Good morning, Solo.
Good morning, guys.
How you? Are you still a state visitor?
I'm happy I can hear you guys.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Namad Miko.
Uh-huh. Uko wapi Solo?
Nashikwa, lakini nimeshikwa mahali pazuri.
What does that mean?
What?
Ameshikwa, lakini ameshikwa mahali pazuri. Please explain. Ni mahali ambapo uko ndio pazuri ama mahali umeshikwa ndio pazuri?
I'm still serving myself. Uzuri hapa mahali niko, hata mahali nimelala.
Mm-hmm.
Niko na ile nini wife. Inaitwa aje?
What you even talking
so about? So let's bless yourself.
Yes.
I even have wife.
And do you have?
He has wine?
Wife. Ile kitu internet inaitwa aje?
Oh, Wi-Fi.
Yeah, oh, Wi-Fi.
You are silly.
Oh, no.
Mali ameshikwa hata kuna wifi. But now, Solo, please make sure uachiliwe haraka na next week we want to have a full account
of what
happened. Ulishikiwa nini?
Ukishikwa hapa uulizi ni nini unasema.
Ati ukishikwa?
Haulizi ni nini ameshikiwa.
But I guess it also depends ni nani amemshika.
Na mahali pale umeshikwa, ukishikwa vizuri, unasema ni sawa, nishikeni.
Okay, Solo needs the Lord. I swear. Solo needs
now,
the Lord.
The
Lord.
Issue here, Asante Sana Solo. Hopefully next week he's going to be here.
I'm enjoying the show with my Wi-Fi. I'm fine, but I'm enjoying.
So, thank you very much, Solo. But now, the thing behind this is that Solo apparently was arrested by a certain woman police constable. And maybe if we can just have her pictures, maybe that will make sense now why he is somehow saying ameshikwa mahali pazuri. Sijui kama ni ule ameshika.
This is the one who has Solo.
This is the police officer apparently who was arrested. By the way, apparently she is actually a police.
Like for real.
Mike, as a matter of fact, we have the story in the paper today and the debate has still be on again. And Solo said,
Solo has been arrested.
I don't mind being arrested by somebody.
It's the purple.
Solo. Yeah, so if this is the arrestee, arrestor,
yes, we see, okay,
right?
No wonder then he's enjoying Wi-Fi. He can't even pronounce it. No wonder he can pronounce it. But anyway, I don't know why it is thought largely when you find a very handsome. You remember the other time we had a very awesome the guy who was in the Pulse, the guy who was literally a police officer but good looking. I don't know why it's expected that police officers are not supposed to be good looking,
Mike.
It's because the ones that stop you have kitam.
Oh, yes, yeah. That is true.
Public opinion.
That is true.
Mike, it's a good thing for Solo not to be in the show today.
Mm.
If that is a problem,
that's a
then it's all right.
Then it's a good problem.
And before we go to the Pulse, because I know we are really out of time, we need to do the Pulse in the Nairobian very quickly, but there was also some grandpa's
Mr.
party.
So your grandma.
Hey.
Let me tell you, that 54-year-old, handsome, with a debonair smile,
you
man.
Know?
His selfies were leaked on Instagram and it went crazy. He literally did what Kim Kardashian did.
He didn't even know, by the way.
He broke the
internet.
And
there is the man himself.
Mr.
How old is he again?
54 years old. He's a teacher.
And we have arrested the man too.
Oh my goodness, there we go.
Oh,
you also have the guy.
Mr. Okay. But then, first of all, let me begin by saying, after I said his selfies leaked and then, the whole world went crazy, he said that he doesn't want anything to do with your grandma.
Okay.
He doesn't want anything to
he's
do with
taken.
Your grandma. He is taken. Yeah.
He is taken. Yeah. He's apparently
taken.
And there was even a picture
taken
of his taker.
But the taker.
Yeah, the taker. There's a picture of the taker. Although, as usual, you know, when you find somebody who's really good looking and you look at the taker, sometimes you're left wondering, okay, what happened?
He has such a debonair smile. Yeah.
Anyway, amazing. From there, why don't we go to the Pulse? Because I can see we also have him on the Pulse on page 19.
We went to the Pulse a long time ago because those are trading topics right now. The police officer there is our spotlight. But again, before we shift from this story, it is a story of the Kenyan girl right now. The story of the Kenyan girl is about the sponsor. You know, that's why the story is big in Kenya, whereby, again, Mr. Mine here, he has a name and all that. Of course, we know he has a name and all that. Mm. Mm-hmm. After this photos came out,
yes.
Kenyan girls, yeah, Nairobians, yeah, some of them, my friends, were like, oh, did you see that, grandpa? I'm thinking, which grandpa and all that? And so Pulse goes ahead and says, so yes, it's the age of the sponsor.
I've been right
now. We used to have a sponsor, but now it's a big thing now.
Mm-hmm.
And Pulse goes ahead to break down the categories of sponsors that we have in this city.
So we have categories of sponsors.
We have categories of sponsors.
He's called Ivan Randall.
Randall. There you go. And so get yourself a copy of the Pulse and find out, especially for those of you who may not even know what this sponsor thing is all about. In South Africa, it's called Blesser.
It has nothing to do with school and academics and... It has something to do with relationships. So let's just keep
and
it
you know, there's also the huge debate that, fine, sponsor has a very negative connotation because you're getting, it's like an exchange. But isn't a relationship an exchange anyway?
Still also
it's
a debate for another day.
Well, moving on and passes.
I'll just leave it at that because
it's hot in here. And again, there she is.
Warrant of attraction. That's on page
that's the police
six.
Officer yes. we are talking
who's
about.
Who's arrested?
Oh, this is the one who was arrested solo.
Yes.
We had a chance to meet
Brenda Wanjiru.
We had a chance to meet Emma, Brenda, actually. And she talks to Paz about her life. And it just brings out the things that you were talking about earlier today. Isn't a police officer supposed to maintain herself, keep herself, not become that rusted fella and all that? And she just speaks about that and says, of course, yes, I know I have all these looks. I know I people are saying this about me. But end of the day, I know what I want in my life and I always need. And this girl, I'll call her a girl because she's 26. Well,
she's a lady.
And she says, my father actually was a police officer. And I grew up just thinking one day I want to go to the police forces. And of course, as a young person who is coming with a new generation, also make a change, end of it. And I think it's a big story that everybody should just and say, and she's warning the sponsors again, I have nothing to do with you guys.
Wow.
I'm just doing my job.
Right.
Okay.
So team self-sponsor is right there. But again, on a more showbiz note, musical talking, we're talking about the big shows again, and this is something we had covered some times ago as Pulse. And Madonna was here as much as she didn't perform. We had beautiful photos of her, but what does this say also say about our showbiz in Kenya and the kind of stability that guys are enforcing in terms of promoters and the musicians to just bring the act back to Kenya? And we know we have many big shows coming in the next few months, and just pass straight to focus the shift of where we have been and where we're moving towards. And I think it's a very positive move that
it
we
is.
Have.
I like it. Looking forward to that. Might we just have to do a show though?
Yeah.
Oh no, definitely. We'll do that. That's in the card. Yeah. So there you have it. Please get yourself a copy of the Standard and get yourself a copy of the Pulse. There's a lot.
Many hot stories, and the overhead is just juicy and all that. Mm-hmm. We talked about the Akothee wedding. Mm-hmm. and I social media went on
I know.
And she's good. And everybody's looking to see who breaks the story.
Mm.
And it just could be something else. Yeah. And it's for you.
Okay. I want us to go to the Nairobian because of time. And let me start with page 30, which is again to do with stereotypes. Okay. And there is a makeover miracle here. What. And Zinzi, I know might what makeup can do. I didn't say anything. Yeah, so
but there was one on social media though.
Yes.
You saw it? There was one on social media which, okay, this one, the makeover is pretty nice and okay.
And by the way, we have her in studio. Another. We have her in studio.
That's her before.
Yes, so I wanted to walk into set, yes. And this lady who's on page 30 of the Nairobian this morning is literally, okay, can she come on studio and maybe just...
And see ya. We see ya.
Yeah, she can walk in. And this is just to do with what a wardrobe can do. Just come in.
She can sit. Stevens.
For a few minutes. And just the stereotypes. And what I want you to do from home is guess what she does for a living. I just want you to guess what she does for a living. And she's on page 30 of the Nairobian this morning. Okay, there you go. And it's literally just talking about how you can make over and have a difference in terms of your looks just by the makeup and the wardrobe that you have.
Woo!
There you go. So page 30. And yeah, there you go. So maybe just tell us a little bit about the makeover that you went through, just very briefly.
Okay.
Your name first. Let's start with your name.
I'm Eunice. Peter.
Eunice Peters.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I was called by a friend, mm-hmm. and she told me that she wanted to do something. Mm-hmm. So I had to go. She just told me what to do. Then we just go, we went, and she did the makeover.
The makeover.
Yeah.
Okay, and there's definitely a huge, huge transformation. Fantastic. I think she deserves a clap. So what I want you to do is let me know. Tell me, what do you think she does for a living? Just let me know. And you'll see how stereotypes play out. I'll see whether I can read it out as we go along. But Stevens, back to you on the Pulse. The Nairobian. And on the front page, we have rich old woman stole my husband, politician's wife. We also have another story there, interesting. Aunt Kiguta gives birth to twins. Uhuru's PA takes paternity leave. Do the math.
That's a story that we should just let... guys grab the Nairobian for, because it's a full page story.
It is.
And I think these guys have done their homework. I read the story yesterday when the paper was out, and you can put the 1+1 according to them and tell everybody what it is. Mm-hmm. But I think it's for the guys to grab their paper and read that. But again, the cover story, the head story, Mike, rich old woman stole my husband. Politician's wife and all that. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's a collection of what's been going on in Nairobi, and we'll never get it wrong in terms of what hot story is in town. Sizi, do you have a chance?
Okay.
First of all, as we were talking about, I have to congratulate Aunt Kiguta twins.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's big.
It's
part of the story.
Well, it's called double for your trouble.
You're behaving like
one, get one free. Go, go.
Yeah. Like, really?
Buy one, get one free. So she bought one, she got one free. All right, we need to wrap up, and maybe I'll start with Adhiambo, one name.
What are
you planning for the weekend? Very briefly, 10 seconds.
Let me tell you, there is a gathering of the sharpest minds per square foot, which is a Luo festival, happening tomorrow.
What did you call it?
A gathering of the sharpest minds per square foot.
So in other words, if you're not there...
Gathering of the sharpest minds. And yes, the VIP treatment, I think we're going to be hitting the red carpet right there. If you want to catch up with me, let's see you there.
Okay. Eunice, what are you doing for the weekend?
Now that makeover has happened.
Now that the makeover has taken place.
I'm going down to Machakos.
She could be. Now we're still guessing what she does. And all that. And talking about Machakos, Masaku 7.
Don't tell us you're going now because
happening. She's going Masaku 7 happening. I mean, she's the new attraction in town for that matter. And now you know I know her. You know. Masaku 7 is happening. A great thing from today, Saturday, Sunday. If you don't get me in this city, then I'll be there. But again, at Galileo's Techno.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
The Nigerian young boy who is our pinup here today
is also doing something. Yeah.
So yes, much happening, and I think I get myself a chopper just to make sure that I come.
That you land in style.
Yes.
Right. For the weekend?
For me, let's see. Sunday, even though it's my day off, I'm going to be coming to work. We're turning 1 year. KTN News, the first local 24-hour news channel. So that's also part of my plan.
Huge birthday.
Saturday, chilling with my girls.
We had agreed about the
red carpet. We agreed about not staying home every time.
What? Lindsay.
Yeah.
Okay. So there you go. That's where we're going to wind up Morning Express this morning in Hot Topics. Thank you so much for staying with us. Do stay with us right here on KTN News. Coming up next, we've got some news updates. Later on, we'll be looking at our Friday chat. And apparently, Kikuyu Valley is really Kikuyu Valley. Apparently. It is official. Yeah, we shall ask our Google map. So apparently Kikuyu Valley is actually called Kikuyu Valley, just to clarify. So it looks like Madonna was right. Yeah, Madonna is right. So we'll wind it up right here. And do stay with us. Some news updates coming up. Later on, we do have Friday chat. And today we'll not be talking about the musicians. We concentrate on the musicians, but there are those who work behind the scenes that ensure music comes out the way we like it. We'll be having that conversation. Don't go away.